Hey guys, ECRG here, back with another episode. Today I've got another question from somebody who listens to the channel on either YouTube or on the podcast. And they are from India and they write in, "Hi, ECRG. I am from India. I have done a Bachelor's of Science in Life Sciences from Delhi University. Now I am doing a Master's in Dietetics and Food from IGNU. Simultaneously, I am doing an internship in Biostats and Epidemiology, Department of ICMR, NICPR. Therefore, I am working on a research paper. Sir, I am keenly interested to make my career in clinical research as a research assistant. For what I am learning, statistics and SPS software too. I would be immensely grateful to you if you could guide me as how should I proceed further for this work and need to learn which new skills too. I am also open to global opportunities. Kindly respond as soon as possible." So thank you so much for your question. I have done a video on how to get jobs in India before. So for those that also want to watch that, you can type in how to get a job in India or how to get a clinical research job in India, and my video should pop right on up if you're listening on YouTube. So to break down your question, you're currently doing a master's in dietetics, and you're also doing an internship in biostatics and epidemiology. So this is a little strange because you want to get into clinical research, but you're doing your master's in dietetics. I don't know why I have a hard time saying that. All right. So first off, I'm not as familiar with the program. Are you paying for this master's or not? But if you don't want to do any things with dietetics and you're still continuing to get this master's, maybe you should see if you could switch it to another master's that's a little bit more applicable to clinical research. Maybe like a master's in pharmacologics, maybe like a master's in biology, or a master's in clinical research itself. They do offer those masters now. So I would see if you could do something a little bit more applicable to clinical research than just getting a master just to get a master's. Because as I've said on this channel numerous times, your degrees do not matter in clinical research. Unless you're being a medical monitor or something like that, your degree does not matter. Once again, I've worked with people in the entry-level job that had PhDs. I've worked with people that had dental degrees. I've worked with people in all types of educational, advanced education. And sure, they got paid a little more than me, but not more than $5,000. And I just had a bachelor's. So your education, as long as you have a bachelor's degree, it does not matter past that if you want to break into clinical research. And I, in fact, argue against it. When I've done people's resumes, I have, in fact, told them to leave off the advanced degree because sometimes that really puts you in a box and recruiters will pass right on over you because they think that you want to get paid more than the job is worth and you're not necessarily going to do that much better than someone else who does not have a degree or the advanced degree. So that's my two cents on that. But you're also doing an internship in biostats and epidemiology. So once again, I would see if you can change your internship to doing it into clinical research. I think that is one of the best ways to get into the clinical research industry is to obviously get some experience. And one of the best ways to get some experience is obviously get an internship. So one, see if you can change your master's degree to a more applicable master's. Two, see if you can change your internship to a more applicable internship. So you have got to get some experience. So even if you complete your master's and this internship, I'm still going to recommend that you do another internship in clinical research. So might as well just do it now because you're going to need some experience. So get an internship in clinical research if you can. So that is my advice on that. And then you want to become a research assistant in clinical research. So you are going to have to find a company that has research assistants. Now, there are plenty of companies. India is not a bad place. It's a growing place for clinical research. So I would also kind of expand your job market into maybe study coordinator, because a lot of studies are going to be run in India coming soon, 2020, 2021, 2022, because it is cheap to run clinical trials there. It is cheaper than other places in the world to run clinical trials there. So I would expand into clinical research coordinator. I would see also see if you can be some kind of clinical trial assistant or something working for a CRO type field, and explore all of these options, because the more broad your work search is, the higher chance of you breaking into the industry. So I would definitely consider that also. And I don't think you need to leave India per se, but if you were, Great Britain is always a good option too, the United Kingdom or Ireland. These places have decent clinical research opportunities, but India really does too, especially as a growing market for clinical research. Plenty of CROs have operations there. IQVIA does, Syneos does. You can work in the TMF. You can be like a TMF not a technician, but they have an entry-level TMF role that is great. And you can apply there. You can go on Indeed. Indeed has a great page for India. And all these companies, all these major pharmaceutical companies have operations going on in India. So you figure out which ones are in your area and you go on and apply. So one of the best ways is to go on Indeed. I talked about this in my other video related to India. And you go on Indeed, you type in your city and look at the clinical research jobs there. Or since you're open to relocation, I would just look anywhere in India. And if they hire you, then you can relocate there. So that's my advice. You should definitely consider, especially because you're at a university, consider if they have clinical research and get in contact with who you need to get in contact with, email, phone call, or show up in person and see if they have any opportunities for you to get an internship. Not many people are going to turn down, you know, paying someone less or even working for free just to get some experience. Not many people are going to turn that down. So that's my advice. You're already at a university, so see what they have opportunities there. See what other opportunities they have at other universities for clinical research and get in contact with those folks. So thank you so much for your question. As always, if you're interested in any resume review help or any interview preparation or any LinkedIn profile makeover, email me eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. Take care.